And now we will learn how to input the financial accounts that Holden has. Financial accounts are my term for the type of accounts that you use to pay from. For example, bank accounts, credit card accounts, even a PayPal account, if you know what that is and you have experience with it, is considered a financial account because money comes in and out of the PayPal account. In fact, even petty cash counts as a financial account because you can pay from petty cash and money comes in and out of the petty cash account. In many small businesses, the petty cash account is physically the owner's wallet. Here are Holden's financial accounts. The names are typical of any small business who puts off their taxes and their bookkeeping till the last minute. So the names are Chase Bank, T&M Bank, Capital One Credit Card, Chase Freedom Credit Card. Holden also has a PayPal account for his business. And of course, all businesses have to have a petty cash account, even if it's really physically the owner's wallet. Now, when you go to put the financial accounts in the chart of accounts, QuickBooks will also ask for the account type. So, Chase Bank is a bank type of account. T&M Bank is a bank type of account. The Capital One credit card and the Chase Freedom credit card are credit card type of accounts. Now, believe it or not, PayPal and petty cash are both bank type of accounts because they both behave the way a bank account would behave. The money comes in and the money goes out. Let's take a look how to put it into QuickBooks. From the main menu, click List Chart of Accounts. These are accounts that QuickBooks already put in the chart of accounts. Now, we'll actually try to remove the accounts that QuickBooks put before we put the ones that we need to put. So how do we do that? Well, you'll find that you can add, edit, or delete any account you want in the chart of accounts. However, if you cannot delete one, you can make it inactive. For example, I can click on this account, Retained Earnings. Now, the bottom left of the chart of accounts controls the window. So after I choose Retained Earnings, I can click Account, Delete Account, and it asks me if I'm sure, and then I click OK, and Retained Earnings is gone. I can also click on Opening Balance Equity, Account, Delete Account, click OK, and it's gone. But look what happens when I try to remove one of the payroll accounts. Account, delete account. I get an error message that says that I'm not able to remove that account. So the only alternative is to make it inactive. Click on the account you want to remove and then click account, make inactive. It doesn't delete the account, it simply hides it from the rest of the list. Let's try that again. This is the last one that's selected. Click Account, Make Inactive, and it's still there, but you cannot see it. If you want to see the accounts that are inactive, you can click this button, and you can see these two accounts are still here, but the X indicates that they are inactive. You can reactivate an account by clicking on it and click Account, Make Account Active, and then it will come back to the list. So make sure when you finish, both of them are inactive, and then you can add the accounts that you need for your business. So now let's put in the accounts exactly as they appear here. Click Account New, and when you do that, the Add New Account window opens up, asking you to choose the type of the first account that we will put. So let's choose Bank. You could always come back to this window and read about the different account types when you click on them. But let's just click Bank and click Continue. Now, this is the window that we will use to put in all of the accounts. The first one is Chase Bank. So let's go ahead and put in the name Chase Bank. Now we click Save and New. Save and New will save the item on the list and clear the window for the next one. Now the next one is also a bank type of account. It's T&M Bank. So we'll leave bank as the selected type and we'll choose T&M. Okay, save and new. Now the next two are credit card accounts, Capital One credit card and Chase Freedom credit card. So let's change the type to credit card and type Capital One, save and new. Leave the account type as credit card and type Chase Freedom. And then let's click Save and New. Now notice the last two accounts, PayPal and Petty Cash or the owner's wallet, are technically bank type of accounts. So let's change this back to bank type of account, type the name PayPal, click Save and New. Now let's type Petty Cash / wallet, because sometimes owners just keep the petty cash of the company in the wallet, but let's make it proper. SH space space. Now on the last one, you can click Save and Close. That'll save the window and close it. Whenever we get a pop-up for some kind of advertisement or something distracting, we can just dismiss it by clicking No. And now we have the financial accounts in the chart of accounts.